The network service page provides the activation of an end device within a LoRa network and the exchange of LoRa radio packets with a LoRa network server over the air. Before an end device is able to transmit data, it has to be activated within the network. The section displays the current activation status and the device EUI of a connected end device and allows to deactivate an end device if required. Device EUI is a global end device ID in IEEE EUI 64 address space that uniquely identifies the end device. Note, the device EUI can be configured to section extras. For this, the customer mode is required. After you have set the device EUI in customer mode, please set the device in application mode again to guarantee proper operation. The activation of an end device can be achieved in two ways, either via over-the-air activation or via activation by personalization. For both, the end device needs the corresponding keys normally provided by the network operator. The parameters required for over-the-air activation and activation by personalization are configurable via HCI interface. These parameters are not readable and they are stored in encrypted form in a non-volatile memory to resist a power cycle. Activation by personalization directly ties an end device to a specific network by passing the join request and join accept procedure. Activating an end device by personalization means that the device address and the two session keys, network session key and application session key, are directly stored into the end device. Each device should have a unique set of network session key and application session key. Compromising the keys of one device shouldn't compromise the security of the communications of the other devices. Enter the three required parameters: device address 32-bit, network session key 128-bit, and application session key 128-bit into the fields. Press Activate Device to write them into the connected end device. For over-the-air activation, end devices must follow a join procedure prior to participating in data exchanges with the network server. The join procedure requires the end device to be personalized with the following information before it starts the join procedure:
a globally unique end device identifier called device EUI, the application identifier called application EUI, and an AES 128-bit application key. The network server will respond to the join request message with a join accept message if the end device is permitted to join a network. The join accept is provided by the network server and used by the end device to derive the two session keys, network session key and application session key. Enter the two parameters, application EUI and application key. Press Set Join Parameter to write the parameters into the end device. Finally, press Join Network to start the join procedure and observe the status box and event table. Within this section, it is possible to send unconfirmed or confirmed data to the server. Enter a LoRaWAN port and some test payload into the fields and press the appropriate button to send a packet. It also offers the possibility to initiate a periodic transmission of radio packets.